In 2001, Uganda was exporting only 700 million liters of milk annually, but this has now rapidly increased to 2.1 billion liters following intervention by government in the agriculture sector. For instance, post-harvest losses have been addressed as more milk coolers are extended to dairy farmers, which in turn translates to more milk for export. Nevertheless, the president is concerned the pricing for milk exported must be regulated to match the international prices, lest Uganda loses the market.
The price should depend on the international price. The national price of milk, because we are exporting much of the milk. So if we overprice our milk here, we shall lose the market. We must be competitive. This is not something to argue about.
Commissioning Pearl Dairy Factory, whose production capacity is estimated at between 200,000 and 300,000 liters a day, he underscored the need for standards to spur competitiveness. He noted that milk consumption by Ugandans remained low despite the increase in the production, which is below the recommendation of the World Health Organization of 3 glasses a day.
The determinant factor is the international price. That's what gives us all the consequences. Because otherwise we shall price ourselves out of the market. Nobody will buy our milk.
The managing director, Paul Dari, says already they are exporting milk and other products to Kenya, Rwanda, South Sudan and Dubai, and export volumes are expected to increase.
I understand that over 10,000 farmers indirectly benefit from supply of milk and other services.
The Farmers Association members in Barara have also received loans to expand their production. As of 2015, Uganda was exporting milk worth $50 million, although the president says this will double as the target now is 10 billion liters to be exported annually.